It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I can never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me wherever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing at all. All day long I can hear people talk.
I would also like to thank you all on their behalf for being here today to help them celebrate their wedding day. My name is Marion, and it is my great pleasure to be conducting the ceremony today, whilst my colleague Julie prepares the marriage certificate and makes the legal and historic record of this marriage in the marriage register. We're here today to witness the joining in marriage of Colin and Diana and to celebrate the beginning of their new life together as husband and wife. It is a statement to all those present of what they already know. They have found such love and friendship that they wish to share the rest of their lives together. This marriage ceremony provides the opportunity for you all to join with them and share in their commitment to each other. So as the marriage ceremony begins, I have to ask the bride and groom to confirm to us all their full names. So if I could ask you both please to stand. Lovely. And starting with you, Colin, I'm afraid we always start with you, it's tradition. If you could confirm your full name.
Colin Nigel Bristow.
And Diana?
Diana Sarah Stanley.
Well, we have the right people then. Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here today in this room that has been duly sanctioned by law for the celebration of marriages. If any person here knows of any just cause or lawful impediment as to why this marriage should not take place, they should speak now. Perfect silence. How much did you pay there? Mr. Alan Stanley, would you like to join us? It has long been a tradition in many parts of the world for the bride to be given in marriage. You are here today to signify in public your happiness with her decision. Are you happy for them to be married?
I certainly am.
And do you wish them well on their journey?
Really much so.
That's lovely. Thank you very much. Okay, you may take your seat. Thank you. Before you two are joined in marriage, I have to remind you both of the solemn and binding character of the ceremony of marriage and of the nature of the promises you are about to make to each other here today. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of one man with one woman, voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. Further, it is a solemn union to provide the love and friendship, help and comfort that each should have for the other, both in times of joy and in times of trouble. It is not to be entered into lightly, nor is it lightly to be set aside. Marriage requires devotion, the ability to listen, and occasionally say sorry. But most of all, it requires unquestioning love and is a journey for two people who care very deeply about each other. Now, at this point, I'd like to ask you to take a seat because we are going to have our first reading. And if James and Tom could join us here at the front. James and Tom.
We thought we'd give our sister some advice on marriage and being a good wife and fairness piece from a 1950s home economics book teaching young women how to prepare for married life.
The Good Wife's Guide. Have dinner ready. Plan ahead, even the night before, to have a delicious meal ready on time for his return. This is a way of letting him know that you've been thinking about him and are concerned about his needs. Most men are hungry when they come home, and the prospect of a good meal, especially his favourite dish, is part of the warm welcome needed.
Prepare yourself. Take 15 minutes to rest so you'll be refreshed when he arrives. Touch up your makeup. Put a ribbon in your hair and be fresh looking. He has just been with a lot of work-weary people. Be a little gay and a little more interesting for him. His boring day may need a lift, and one of your duties is to provide it. Clear away the clutter. Make one last trip through the main part of the house just before your husband arrives. gather up school books, toys, paper, etc., and then run a dust cloth over the tables.
Over the cooler months of the year, you should prepare and light a fire for him to unwind by. Your husband will feel he has reached a haven of rest and order, and it will give you a lift too. After all, catering for his comfort will provide you with immense personal satisfaction. Prepare the children. Take a few minutes to wash their hands and faces, if they are small, and comb their hair, and if necessary, change their clothes. They are little treasures, and he would like to see them playing the part.
At the time of his arrival, eliminate all noise from the washer, dryer, and vacuum. Try to encourage the children to be quiet. Be happy to see him. Greet him with a warm smile and show him sincerity in your desire to see him. Listen to him. You may have a dozen important things to tell him, but the moment of his arrival is not the time. Let him talk first. His topics of conversation are more important than yours.
Make the evening his. Never complain if he comes home late. Instead, try to understand his world of strain and pressure and his very real need to be at home and relax. Your goal, try to make sure your home is a place of peace, order and tranquility, where your husband can renew himself in body and spirit. Don't greet him with complaints and problems. Don't complain if he's late for dinner or even if he stays out all night. Count this as minor compared to what he might have gone through that day.
Make him comfortable. Have him lean back in a comfortable chair or have him lie down in the bedroom. Have a cool or warm drink ready for him. Arrange his pillow and offer to take off his shoes. Speak in a low, soothing and pleasant voice. Don't ask him questions about his actions or question his judgment or integrity. Remember, he is the master of the house and a good wife always knows her place.
James, I'm not sure. Things are definitely like this in my house.
Not mine. When did it all change? You think we've got a time machine?
I'm not sure when it changed. So, although this is an excellent piece of advice for Dinah, we really don't have much hope for you, Colin. Married life will quite like be like this. We do know, however, that you are very lucky to be spending the rest of your life with our little sister.
Oh. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. I think it's
better. Yeah.
I'm now going to ask each of you in turn to declare that you know of no legal reason why you should not be joined together in marriage. You just need to repeat these words after me, and again we'll start with you, Colin. Okay. I declare that.
I declare that.
I know of no legal reason.
I know of no legal reason.
Why I, Colin Nigel Bristow.
Why I, Colin Nigel Bristow.
May not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Diana Sarah Stanley.
To Diana Sarah Stanley.
Well done. And Diana. I declare that.
I declare that.
I know of no legal reason.
I know of no legal reason.
Why I, Diana Sarah Stanley.
Why I, Diana Sarah Stanley.
May not be joined in marriage.
May not be joined in marriage.
To Colin Nigel Bristow.
To Colin Nigel Bristow.
Now that you have declared you are free to marry, this brings us to the point where you take each other as husband and wife. The few words you are about to say will take you across another threshold, for after these words, you will say to the world, "This is my husband and this is my wife." And to hear these special words, we need to have our two special witnesses, David and Richard, here at the table, please. And if everybody could stand at this point, you can turn and face each other, because the words you're saying to each other and not to me. And again, starting with you, Colin, just repeat after me. I, Colin Nigel Bristow.
I, Colin Nigel Bristow.
Take you, Diana Sarah Stanley.
Take you, Diana Sarah Stanley.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
And my faithful partner.
And my faithful partner.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
And Diana? I, Diana Sarah Stanley.
I, Diana Sarah Stanley.
Take you, Colin Nigel Bristow.
Take you, Colin Nigel Bristow.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
And my faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
And Colin, if you could repeat after me. I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To support you in your goals.
To support you in your goals.
To honour and respect you.
To honour and respect you.
To laugh and cry with you.
To laugh and cry with you.
And to cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
And to cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
And Diana, if you could repeat after me. I promise to love you unconditionally.
I promise to love you unconditionally.
To support you in your goals.
To support you in your goals.
To honour and respect you.
To honour and respect you.
To laugh and cry with you.
To laugh and cry with you.
And to cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
And to cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
We have come together today in the presence of your family and friends to witness the commitment you are making to each other. So Colin, do you, Colin, choose Diana to be your partner in life, to love and protect her in good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles you may face, completely and forever?
I do.
And Diana? Do you, Diana, choose Colin to be your partner in life, to love and protect him in good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles you may face, completely and forever?
I do.
Now we come to the exchange of the rings. So David and Richard, if you could come forward with the rings, and Colin, if you could take the ring that you're going to give to Diana and pop it on her finger and her left hand, and just hold it in place as you say these words, just halfway along for the moment. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And my love for you.
And my love for you.
I promise to be there when you need me.
I promise to be there when you need me.
And believe in our future together.
And believe in our future together.
I commit myself to our marriage.
I commit myself to our marriage.
Okay, if you want to pop that all the way on now. Give it a twist. Excellent. I don't think that one's coming off. And Diana, if you could take the ring that you're going to give to Colin. And pop it on his finger on his left hand, also halfway along. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And my love for you.
And my love for you.
I promise to be there when you need me.
I promise to be there when you need me.
And believe in our future together.
And believe in our future together.
I commit myself to our marriage.
I commit myself to our marriage.
You pop that all the way on. May these rings, which by long tradition form a seal to the marriage contract, be a reminder to you both of the vows you've made to each other here today. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. It has no beginning and no end and symbolises unending love. So if you'd like to have a seat for the moment, and if you guys could take a seat for the moment, let Max and Luke will join us for the second reading.
James Dillip Freeman. May your marriage bring you all the exquisite excitements a marriage should bring, and may life grant you also patience, tolerance, and understanding. May you also need one another, not so much to fill your emptiness, as to help you to know your fullness.
May you need one another, but not out of weakness. May you want one another, but not out of lack. May you entice one another, but not compel one another. May you embrace one another, but not out-encircle one another.
May you succeed in all the important ways with one another, and not fail in the little graces. May you look for the things to praise, often say I love you, and take no notice of small faults.
If you have quarrels that push you apart, may both of you hope to have good sense enough to take the first step back. May you be warm and near when you are side by side, in separate rooms or even distant cities.
May you have happiness, and may you find it making one another happy. May you have love, and may you find it loving one another.
Thank you. Thanks very much. Let's serve a round of applause. Joining of two people, a union of two hearts, it will thrive on the love that you give each other. May you always be able to talk things over, confide in each other, laugh with each other, but also share moments of quiet and peace. But above all, remember what brought you together and remain the very best of friends. You have both made the declarations required by law. You've made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your family and friends and before Julie and myself. And we all hope the coming years hold much happiness and contentment for you both. I am now delighted to announce you are now husband and wife and husband.